Welcome back, everybody. If you are looking for home decoration advice, there is one person to go to. She's sitting right here to the left of me. Her name is Paige Hemmis. So whether it's staging a home to sell or just refreshing a room, Paige, you always have everybody covered.
Yes.
You really do. So what's the most important thing when it comes time to sprucing up your space?
When it comes time to spruce up, I think don't be afraid, and don't be afraid to ask for help.
Okay, that's always good.
Yes, and because it kind of seems a little...
daunting.
A little overbearing when you're starting, especially now with the way we have open concept rooms and houses, you don't kind of know where to start. That's actually a question I get a lot is, okay, we've moved into this house, we can see the kids while we're in the kitchen, everything looks great, where do I put a chair or a sofa?
Right. I can't even tell you how many times I've, like, bought something and then brought it back to my house and been like, what did I do?
Where
and
I
got it custom, so I can't bring it back, or like,
I put it?
Don't know where to put it. And you know, if we all had one of you in our homes, we could just ask lovely Paige Hemmis, but we don't all have a Paige Hemmis in our home. So.
But you can.
Okay.
You can. Yes.
You're going to be spread pretty thin.
Cloning going?
Yeah.
Yes. You can really hire me for quite some money. No.
For the right price.
For free. Actually, there are people from Lazy Boy who come and do in-store and then in-home, yes, free
what?
In-home designing consultations.
Oh, free?
Oh my gosh.
Free, yes.
You know how I like that.
You know, exactly.
Well, yes. It's my favorite price.
Exactly. Yeah, fabulous and frugal. Yeah. Ken Wingard over here. So where do you start? Where's the first place to start when you stage? Because again, like you said, you come mm-hmm. in, there are no walls, where do I put a couch?
Yes.
So okay. What's the first thing to do when you start staging?
The first thing you do is pick something large, like the sofa that we're on, and go for a neutral tone. So that way, no matter what else you have in the house that you're trying to match it with, or if you know you want to spruce it up different times of the year, you have a nice kind of blank palette,
okay.
A little blank slate to start, and definitely start with the sofa.
Well, I okay. love that because I feel like the pieces you chose to go around the sofa are so beautiful.
Really
so
are.
Tell us about some of the other things you picked.
This ottoman I'm in love with.
So beautiful.
Yes, and ottomans too. Everyone's going like, well, what should I do? Should I use it as a coffee table? Should I put my feet up? You know what? You can do both.
And it works great for kids, just like we were saying, mm-hmm. because if you have little ones, you don't want sharp edges.
Yes.
So they're not going to fall down and hit their heads. And
exactly.
End up in
so in that,
this
I would...
one also, it's like super modern, which is really
right.
nice. It's like a nice, because often you can also think of ottomans as a little bit sort of like old fashioned, mm-hmm. but doing it in a modern shape with this modern
yes.
print, very cool.
Agreed. This is kid friendly. This, the accessories, you might want to go with something
so
a little
that's
softer.
Very chic.
Yes.
So, if you are going with a neutral vibe mm-hmm. for the sofa, what about the other pieces of furniture and the things? Does it work for all seasons? Do you know what I mean?
Yes.
Because sometimes you can change from season to season.
Exactly. What I love, and this is kind of like a blank slate, but Ken, if you could, hand me just those darker cushions.
Let's say
this is kind of summery, and then we're going into fall. I'll actually take both of them there, and we can even leave those. But going into fall, you can pick something a little bit darker like this. Ah, and now maybe in fall, then get rid of those. When Christmas comes around, you have Christmas, but your base is constantly going to match what you've got going.
So the best thing to do then is stick with a solid neutral base mm-hmm. because then it's always going to work.
And then
house.
You can add fabulous things like the things you girls are sitting
I got to say, I want to do the rest
great.
Of the show right from the
chair.
It is so comfortable.
One of the best things about this, if I may cut in front of you over here, is this nail head detail. And it goes all the way around the back, which makes it look like it's so fancy.
And
but not only
way,
that, but also in the sofa, the tufting on the sofa, which is incredibly nice. All these little details are really nice.
And the nail heading.
You know, I feel like sometimes too, when you're shopping for furniture, sometimes you have to sacrifice structure for comfort. But this has both. Like I feel like it's got a beautiful structure, but it's so comfortable.
And like I love.
You can't stay in there for the whole show.
Yeah,
we're close to the end. This is very comfortable right here.
And I know these are gorgeous the way they are.
Yes.
But the best thing about it is that you can customize. Let's say you want a special pattern or fabric. You can customize your chairs to whatever you want.
That's true.
But if you are feeling overwhelmed, I say don't just have one of their designers come in. They can do in-house designing help for you. So you don't need a million of
them. Yeah. No, it's pretty awesome. They'll go through the book and show you all the fabrics. You get to touch them. You can see
and
the colors.
And they do it in
it's
your
great.
Home, so you can see if it matches your drapes
nice.
Or
so you don't
the
have
other
to, like,
pieces.
Get swatches and then you back and forth. That's nice.
That's what
so
I
So I'm going to be here. Just
you
kicking back.
You guys chill. We're going to sit here for a moment, too. And I'd just like to remind all of you guys, Lazy Boy can help you out with your whole new house, not just the living room. Check it all out at lazyboy.com.